Good morning everyone, this is Niketa from Indian Homeschoolers in US. This video is about morning baskets. If you don't know what a morning basket is, if you've never heard about it, let me tell you. A morning basket is a collection of activities that you do in the morning together as a family. Now it's a great productive way to start your day. It helps you transition into your school day a little bit better. You know, no kid likes to get up in the morning and start studying right away. So if you introduce this morning basket, you know, you can have all the kids together and slowly you get on to your daily routine. This way, you know, the sleepiness and everything is taken care of before you start the school day. So let me show you what our morning basket looked like when the kids were a little younger. They're teenagers now, so things have changed a little bit. This is what it looked like. I'm going to go over what things are in there, but it doesn't have to be a basket. It could be a basket, box, container, a corner on the shelf. The idea is just to have all these things together in one place so that in the morning you're not thinking, what should I do today or where did I keep it? You know, you're not scrambling around looking for these things. It's just in one place. So that's the morning basket. That's what it looks like. What we have in ours, you know, before that, let me tell you that what I like to do, the way we structure our kids' first hour when they get up in the morning, is we like to have three things in there. We have something for the body, something for the soul, and something for the mind. For the body, of course, exercise. You know, the kids run around the block a couple of times, or you know, they do some if it's cold outside, they do exercises in the house, like, you know, sit-ups, push-ups, those kind of things. You know, watch something. I put on an aerobics for kids video, and they would watch that and they would follow that. So this is just to get their blood pumping in the morning. So that's for the body. For the soul and for the mind is what I have in the basket. So let me show you what I have for the soul. So for the soul, we read some scripture books. So, you know, you got your some mythology books. You got your Ramayana, or you got your Mahabharata, or this is the Gita for children. So, you know, I have these books. So this is a good way to teach these stories, teach mythology to the kids, and, you know, have them spiritually grounded. So this is what we do in the morning basket. And we do these as a read aloud because, you know, the kids, they've been born and brought up over here. So some of the names, they're a little bit harder for them to pronounce and remember. So if we are doing it together, we talk about it, we discuss it. So it just makes the retention a little bit better. So that's for what we do for the soul. For the mind, you know, you can go wild over here. There are a lot of different things you can do. What I used to have sometimes I would have some character building stories in there. So there's book like The 7 Habits of Highly Happy Kids. Then there are a lot of character building books. Like this one is The Value of Believing in Yourself. It's the story of Louis Pasteur. So it's in a story format, and you know, it teaches you some message. There are a lot of books that you can do for character building, like honesty, integrity, those kind of things. Also, you know, when you're in India, maybe you can pick up some moral story books. We read a lot of those when we were kids. Or maybe some Panchatantra. They have small stories, and you know, they're very small, interesting stories and fun stories. So, you know, this is what we used to read when the kids were younger. And there are a lot of library books in the library also that teach about you know, these good models and all. You can pick up those from there. Who Was series. So I'm sure you all have seen the Who Was series in libraries and Barnes and Nobles and all the bookstores. This is a great way to teach the kids about, you know, a person. You know, what we used to do is just read it a little bit, and every day, you know, 15-20 minutes, and then catch up the next day, continue the next day. So you have the Who Was series, you have Where Is series. We had only the Who Was series when the kids were younger, but now they have the Where Is and the What Were, What Is series as well. This is a great way, you know, even if your younger kids don't understand everything, they will get a little bit, they will retain a little bit, and when they are older, it just will help them having all this knowledge, you know, stored somewhere up there. So this is a great way. Then, you know, you could even do themed morning baskets. You know, 1 month you could do stories about inventors, 1 month you could do stories about ocean animals, you know, you get the drift, right? Ocean animals, African animals, that kind of a thing. So you could have a theme baskets, or you could do some easy read aloud stories, some fun stories, some funny stories. Then there is this Arabian Nights. We read Tales from Arabian Nights, and you can get a lot of this stuff from the library. So this is what we have in my morning basket. Apart from this, if you have younger kids, you know, really small kids, what you can have is something to keep them distracted. But because you know they will disrupt a little bit, so you could have some markers and crayons and coloring books. You know, this even like dot to dot if they can do the numbers. So you can have these kind of books while you're working with the older kids. So these are some of the ideas that you can have in your morning baskets. What I like to do is essentially keep in mind that, you know, what are things that I would like the kids to learn about that I don't get the time to do during the school time. And those are some of the things that I put in my morning basket. So I hope this helps. And if you like this video, do give me a thumbs up. Do press the thumbs up button, give me a like, and do subscribe. So have a great rest of the day, and happy homeschooling, you guys.